In this video, we show you how to work on the jobs that have been approved. So for this, notice we are logged in as the technician. In the upper right-hand corner, we have TC because we are logged in as Technician C. So next, let's navigate to our repair order. Now that the technician has been notified that the parts are here, we're going to move into the Work in Progress tab. Here we can see that the advisor changed the status to Work Not Started because the parts have arrived. Now beneath that, we have a battery service, an oil change, a tire plug, and we have to replace a belt. So the next, the technician would want to hit the green play button. That will start the job clock, and it will automatically change the status to in progress. Once the technician performs the battery service, when they're done, they would hit the checkbox to the right of the labor operation to finish it. Finishes the job, it stops the job clock, and it puts a line through the labor operation that they've completed. So next is the oil change. So we're going to begin to run time. So this is our job clock. Here you can see how efficient our technicians are by seeing how long it's taken them to perform these jobs. Once he's done with the oil change, we would hit the checkbox to the right and complete it. Now next, let's take a look at the belt job. We're going to begin to run time on it. If the technician forgot to run time and they want to update this, either your advisors or your manager more than likely has permissions to update the time. Now here you'll notice that we're putting a belt and a pulley on it. We do give indicators for cores, so the technician knows to put the part back in the box, back on the core shelf, so we can get our money back for it. Now if for any reason we have a part that comes in incorrectly, your technician can add a comment by selecting Add Comment. Then here, let's specify that we got the wrong part, whatever it might be. And then we would send it back to our advisor, or we could send it back to a number of advisors. Let's also send service writer B. So this is not customer facing. Customers will never see these comments. This is just for us to have a dialogue with our technicians in the back. So the advisors can come back into their profile and comment back if they need to. But once we're done with this job, we're going to mark the labor operation complete. It'll stop the clock, and we have one more job to do. But first, let's go back to the job board. Here, that timeline that we have at the bottom of repair order says that we're 84% done because we finished 3 out of 4 jobs. So let's jump back into it. Back in the Work in Progress tab. And then when we're ready to work on our last job, we can. And when we're completely done with this job, we want to hit the checkbox to the right to complete it. Now back on the job board, you'll notice that we're 100% done. Your advisor would see this as well. Then they can touch up the ticket and notify the customer.
Thanks for watching. Please do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and to share it with the rest of your team. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you would like to see more helpful videos for auto repair shops. Have a wonderful day.